James Cross.
Let's just take a moment to show our love and respect for the longest reigning IWU Next Gen Champion, James Cross. He's had that title for 224 days, and tomorrow he'll be celebrating his 225th day as the champion.
Well, that's normally what happens after 224, but I think the reign ends here. Ritmo may have faced two men already tonight, but he's got the fire, he's got the determination, he's got the ability to beat Cross.
The classic family virus has infected the IWU.
Absolute disgrace of people. Of a family, you call them a family? They wouldn't know what a family was if it smacked them on the behind.
Hey, you say that to our illustrious leader and the world champion, because them two are tight, as family should be. Like a stone, they're rock solid.
Look at Nero Classic giving pep talk here to James Cross.
Look at that. That's a champion that we can believe in.
That's a champion until the end of this match.
Do you know what? Haven't we seen enough of this guy already? He should have just done the right thing backstage and said, I've been here, I've had a match, I'm just going to go home.
He won. He won, so he gets the title match.
And he's hobbling out. He's hobbling out. You know what they say about a one-legged man in a butt-kicking contest. What's he doing? What's he doing with that poster of our illustrious leader? Show some respect. Show some respect to our illustrious leader.
Show the respect
Nero Classic
that he deserves.
This is disgusting.
Oh, there it goes.
That's disgusting. What a disgrace.
Just where your illustrious leader deserves to be. On his face.
Do you know what? I should go there and I should put
Sit
that up.
Sit down, you're a pacifist.
I should put that back up.
Go and find it.
After the match, maybe I will. Maybe I will. Because, do you know what? I would like to go and speak to our illustrious leader about getting a copy of that poster, autograph by him. He's a busy man. If he's got time to do it, I don't know if he's going to be at the meet and greet, but it'd be lovely. It'd be an honour. But
I'm sure
the disrespect.
I'm sure a vapid man like that will be front and centre trying to meet all of the fans that don't care about him.
Everybody's here because of him. We're at a packed arena here. Why? Because of the last show, the Civil War, Classic Family Virus, were victorious,
ladies
and that
and
brought
gents,
us here today.
This match is for the Next Gen title. Defending the title, we have James Cross of the Classic Family Virus.
What a stud.
And his opponent, let's hear it for Ritmo.
What a spud.
He's in the match, he's got a chance. As long as that Mr. Classic keeps his nose out of the mat.
Our illustrious leader,
your
Nero Classic. Once again, just to remind you, he is paying your wages. Right. So, do you know what? I'm going to speak to him later. I'm going to see if we can get you replaced at the next show. Either that, or I'm just going to do this by myself.
You can't replace the best commentator in the country.
If you put as much effort into your commentary as you did in your appearance, you'd still be a rubbish commentator.
Thanks for the words of advice.
Anytime. Well, now, let's watch another champion at work here.
See, already getting involved in the match. Just because it's a no DQ. Ritmo on absolute fire here. James Cross doesn't know what hit him. And I can tell you what's hit him. Ritmo.
Well, I don't think he's hitting anything today. His leg is all mashed up. He's already had to fight two of the Classic Family Virus members in the Unstoppable Steve Pym and Terry Is It.
and he barely scraped through. Look at him. He can't even run the ring without falling over. There is absolutely no way that he's going to be able to defeat the longest reigning next-gen champ in James Cross. It's just not going to happen.
That knee looks like it's blown out. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm not even sure how long this is going to last now. I mean, you've got to give him some credit for coming out here with that leg like that. But I fear for Ripmo right now.
Well, there is that old saying that if you're going to be tough, you've got to be dumb. And he is the dumbest of the dumb.
Oh, so that's why you think you're intelligent, because you're not tough.
Look, right? I never claim to be tough, but I do claim to be incredibly intelligent.
Well, that's beggar's belief. Absolute control by James Cross now. I am losing hope for this match. I will admit. Ripmo's got to do something really special to get back and stay in this match.
I just don't think he's got it in him. He calls himself the Rogue Lucha. The Rogue Lucha. Lucha is in Lucha Libre. You know what that means, right? It's by the book. Do you know what book he's made of that he read that turned him into a wrestler? The Idiot's Guide to Wrestling. That's what. He should have just stayed at home.
I don't think a man that doesn't know how to wrestle should comment on a man that is currently wrestling in the ring.
Most of the greatest commentators of all time were not in-ring performers.
At least I've been trained.
That's something. Do you know who did wrestle a match? Michael Cole. He's rubbish as well.
That's very true, Rap. Can't wait to face him at WrestleMania. Anyway, absolute controlled here by James Cross, the champion.
Of course. He's been in control for the last 224 days. There hasn't been a moment where he has lost control. He is the next-gen champ for a reason.
Yeah, but how many defenses has he actually had in that time?
How many times has he lost the belt in that time? So it doesn't really matter. Again, it's much of a muchness. The only person, realistically, on the roster that you could compare to James Cross is A-Star Andy Paul. Again, an undefeated champion. These two men are the men with the gold.
What about Steve Pym?
Steve Pym is a giant amongst men. He is a giant man.
Yeah, so you don't think
there's a pecking order, though.
Can take out Cross?
I didn't say that. I just said there's a pecking order. And the pecking order goes right at the top, Nero Classic. Right next to him, A-Star Andy Paul. And then just below is the longest reigning next-gen champ, James Cross.
The toys are out, ladies and gentlemen. Oh, and he's broke that wood right over James Cross's back.
Disgusting. Absolutely disgusting.
It's a no DQ. It's all legal. How can you call that disgusting when you've watched Nero Classic get involved in this match within the first minute?
Yeah, but Nero Classic is the illustrious leader of the Infected Wrestling universe. He can technically do whatever he wants. That's so right, my boy. They. That's right. So there's snapped it across his back.
There's a hypocrisy from you. When Ripmo does it, disgusting. When James Cross does it, justified.
Hey, look, Ripmo can't even spell hypocrisy. And to be fair, tomorrow morning, he's not going to be able to even say it because most of his teeth are going to be knocked out.
I mean, that's a visual I'd rather not have in my mind right now, but we will see about that.
Can we just acknowledge for a minute what that jabroni Ian is doing at ringside as well in his spangly jacket?
Yeah, it looks great.
He lost control, along with Danny West, of the IWU last show at the Civil War. And he comes out here, he's cheering on
moral
Ripmo.
Moral support. Moral support. Oh, he set him up on the post, but Ripmo moves out of the way. James Cross is feeling the sting now in his fingers.
I'm not sure he moved out of the way. I think he crumpled out of the way because his knee is just a broken bag of dust in his leg.
Did it work, though? Yes, it did. Oh, rolls into him with a cannonball on the outside.
I don't think that was a roll. I think he slipped. Bagheera left some of his dust there on the ringside and he slipped. He slipped on him.
Looked like a decent cannonball to me, Mario. Ripmo getting him back in the ring, trying to get that energy from the fans to win this next-gen championship.
Look, he's got the crowd behind him. That is true.
Oh, dragon screw leg whip.
You know who else used to have the crowd behind him? James Cross.
Yeah.
And when that happened, he was absolutely obliterated by Paul Malin. Do you know what he did? He stood by the side of our illustrious leader, Nero Classic, sat under his learning tree, and what happened?
He became a champion,
and he is the longest reigning and defending IWU Next Gen champion.
Was he the first?
Does it matter?
Yeah.
He wasn't the first, actually. He's the longest reigning. You're thinking of A-Star Andy Paul, who was the first IWU World Heavyweight Champion.
Right. Okay, so who was the first Next Gen champion? Enlighten me with your knowledge.
Look at this maneuver right here.
He's got the German.
See, do your job. German suplex.
Unbelievable. James Cross showing his talent, his undeniable talent. He wouldn't be champion without it, or without our illustrious leader.
Do you know, as much as I love and respect Team Wynn, and I do respect them a lot. If could you imagine if Terry Izzard and Steve Pym team up to take them on for the World Tag Team Championship belts? Then,
cardboard championship belts.
Then the Classic Family Virus would not only be running the company, but they'd have all the gold. All the gold.
Oh, reversal, head first into the chair. James Cross is knocked for six.
Ashes not low. What happened to your boy six anyway? Oh, I swear he became number two. Oh, that was just the smell. Anyway, let's go, James Cross.
Did he get pinned?
James Cross has not been pinned yet. He is still the IWU longest reigning Next Gen champion.
Spinning heel kick into the chair, into the face. And he is looking very much worse for wear, your boy James Cross.
Let's just say, Ritmo doesn't exactly look like he's all sunshine and roses right now. And neither would I be with a big elbow from James Cross in the bush.
Oh, they're going at it now, backwards and forwards. Ritmo still standing on that dodgy knee.
But it's he's a one-legged man.
Yes, but the adrenaline.
Oh! And what happened to that one leg? Chopped down.
He is still in this match, though. James Cross looking to end it. Oh, he's caught him. He's rolled him up for the championship. Oh, he's kicked him out too.
Sneaky little so-and-so thought he had it there, but he didn't, did he?
Uranagi! Ladies across for the lateral press. Oh, 2.99 ad infinitum.
Oh, I was a little bit worried there.
That was the closest I've seen tonight.
That's the closest I've seen James Cross come into losing that title. Come on, James.
Ritmo is right on the edge of winning this now.
I'm not really sure what our illustrious leader would actually say or do if James Cross lost the title tonight. Ritmo, he can't beat three members of the Classic Family Virus. He just can't.
Turn inside and out by James Cross. Oh. Hooks the leg, looking to retain his title. Ritmo kicks out at two. Still in this.
There's no way. No, I won't believe it, though.
You won't believe that James Cross can lose, but he can. He is still just a man.
Well, Ritmo is also just a man, but he's a man with a shattered knee. Do you know what? At the end of the day, he's probably going to end up at the same hospital ward as Stealth, and they can both be there. One's got a cast on his left leg. The other will have a cast on their right leg. It will look funny, won't it? They can do a cute little YouTube video together or something.
Very aggressive for a pacifist. Maybe you're a masochist.
But the champion is in control.
Not for long. Ritmo changing that, blocking the superplex, biting the head.
He's been spending too much time with that. Oh, Corey Kendricks.
Showed up well for his title match, Corey Kendricks. But here goes Ritmo with a frog splash. Oh! Can he get the pin, though?
I think he hurt himself more than he hurt James Cross.
That knee is looking absolutely destroyed.
Oh, what an idiot.
Ritmo gets... Oh, no. James Cross has got the chair. Oh, right on the kneecap.
That's it. It's game over.
Ref, you've got to call this.
Over.
No. No, not in the chair. I can break his leg. Oh.
Well, he could say that, you know, he had the opportunity to no-show this match. He knew that he was, you know, in a world of pain, and he still decided to show up.
Will he walk again after this? That's the case. He's hooked up the leg. It's a heel hook. Oh, Ritmo can't last much longer in this. The knee bar, the heel's hooked.
That idiot Ian standing at ringside, instead of standing there like a slack-jawed yokel, he should be on his phone dialing 999, calling for an ambulance right now.
Ah, oh, there it is. Ritmo valiant in his attempt.
Your winner, James Cross.
Still the next-gen champion, James Cross.
Longest reigning IWU next-gen champion. Tomorrow, 225 days. The day after, 226 days. Okay. The day after that, 227 days. The day after that, 228 days.
Come on, we know we're out of count.
What a champion, what a stable, what a leader.
This Kettering crowd is stunned.
Oh, and here come the rest of the classic family virus.
Pimmin, is
it? Never any doubt at all.
Where's your A-star, huh?
Yeah, did you not hear? Got the rest of the night off. He went home.
Where's my banner? It's one of the Goon Squad. Bring out my banner.
Bring it back.
We end this show on the highest of highs. With the classic family virus standing on top.
The lowest of lows.
Bring that banner out. Bring that banner back out. Come on.
Dark cloud has come over IWU. It's no longer the independent wrestling universe.
Come on, Goon Squad.
This is now the infected wrestling universe.
And it's all thanks to those men in that ring. Especially, what is this? What is this? What?
No.
Oh! That's been defaced.
Defaced?
I fired them!
Disgraced.
The imperfects must be still around. Look at it. Look at that poster. Everyone's looking around. Where are they? Where are they?
They were here. They were fired. It must have been one of these idiot fans. Thought that they could deface that.
A little bit of graffiti.
Oh, Ritmo chucked up the ring.
That doesn't change the fact that we are on top. Ritmo's down and out. There's nobody left. There's nobody left to try and save you from the classic family bar.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are tonight's entertainment.
No.
What did you say?
They were fired!
Huh?
They were fired!
They are!
Get out of here! Security! Take them out!
Mr. J!
This is
perfect to hear!
It's vandalism! It's vandalism by this walking freak show!
What are you gonna do about it?
No, before you talk! I fired you guys. You should be getting out of here. You should have got out of here a long time ago. Where are the Goon Squad? What am I paying you for?
What are the Goon Squad going to do, though? That's what I say. This one doesn't even look older than 12.
You lot stand down for a second. Take it easy for a second while I talk to this tub of nuts.
Absolute disgusting.
Now,
tub of guts.
How are you all doing?
Very good, Mr. J. How are you, my friend?
You go wash your ass, you stink.
So, you didn't read the contract, did you, sir?
Ooh. Shenanigans afoot.
I told you! That contract, I beg you, I said, are you sure? Let's play the footage, Simon.
You surely don't want to read this. You surely don't want to read this. Someone said hello, my friend.
You dumb fat tit.
This is just absolute disrespect.
Because what Danny West did, knowing how you roll, and I had a feeling that kiss ass Andy Ball was going to pull some crap, you know, because blood's thicker than water, so's caramel. But!
Good point.
But! I had it in my back pocket too, that Danny West made two stipulations on that contract, which you failed to read.
You've got to read the contract, Mario.
One of them being that the Imperfects are signed as active members of the IWU roster with an ironclad contract, which means we can never be fired.
Oh, what a nightmare. What a nightmare.
And the second clause was, I get to make a match of my choosing.
Ooh.
Now, you're all going to probably think that, yeah, Mr. J and Mr. Munson are going to take back IWU. That's a little bit boring for us. So what I've decided, checking out that Seth Rogen looking dude in the ring there.
That's the next gen champ he's talking about. Disgraceful.
You're about as vain as Nero is, and it really annoys me. So, what we're going to do, September 23rd, you're going to face Nathan Archer for the next gen title in a hair versus hair match.
Oh!
Now, Nero, I know you're new to the job, so I took it upon myself to already get the posters to spring it up for September 23rd. They'll be out in the foyer after the fans have finished the show. So, the reason I did that match and not anything to do with you guys is because we want to stick around and piss you off.
I'm for that.
Now, me and Monster have got a couple of new shirts out here. I don't know if you guys have checked them out or bought anything.
I've got three.
Woo!
I'll be
gross. I wouldn't use them as toilet paper.
We're getting a new catchphrase over. We're going to shout, you want to get nuts? You lot are going to shout, let's get nuts. So,
are you ready?
One, two, three. You want to get nuts?
Let's get nuts!
Sheeple. Absolute sheeple.
Yep, he's right. They are sheep. Absolute sheep. They've been hanging out with that Bagheera too long.
It looks like Bagheera, no?
This is the disrespect to our illustrious leader is just rank and vile. Rank and vile. I can't even talk. I'm just distraught at this. They were fired. Damn it, fired.
But they can't be fired. Ironclad contracts. What do you think Pim and Izzet are going to do here against Mr. Monster? Oh, there goes Izzet and Mr. J. That was quick. Cross and Pim attacking the Imperfects. But Imperfects are on top. Oh, Pim thrown into Cross. Mr. Monster, throw it, Mr. J.
I'm just flabbergasted.
Poetry in motion.
But they had matches. They're not fresh. They're not fresh.
Cutter. Oh. Boom, right on the top of his head.
But our longest reigning IWU Next Gen Champion, James Cross, has just had a match, and these, I can't even call them thugs. They're just...
Imperfect.
But they've attacked him. Why? It's just unprovoked. It's unnecessary.
How is it unprovoked?
They lost the Civil War. Get out of here.
Nero Classic tried to fire them.
This is our illustrious leader, Nero Classic, that you're talking about.
You may call him that, but to me, he's just Nero Classic.
You're in denial.
No, I'm at commentary desk with Karen.
Now, I expect to see each and every one of you here September 23rd.
I'll be here.
Now, let's see if your memories are any good. Do you guys want to get nuts?
Let's get nuts.
Play our music.
The infected family virus absolutely stunned here tonight.